President Joe Biden breaks his silence on the growing protests across colleges in the U.S. Speaking at the White House, Biden said both freedom of speech and the rule of law must be respected during demonstrations over the war in Gaza.
We are not an authoritarian nation where we silence people or squash dissent. The American people are heard. In fact, peaceful protest is in the best tradition of how Americans respond to consequential issues. But, neither are we a lawless country. We are a civil society, and order must prevail.
Escalating campus protests are forcing Biden to walk a careful line of denouncing anti-Semitism while supporting the right to protest of Americans. As violent police crackdown spread, Biden also faces sharp criticism of his Israel policy. In the span of 2 weeks, over 2,000 arrests have been made in protests all across U.S. universities. Turkey suspends all trade with Israel, citing the worsening humanitarian situation in Palestinian territories. Turkey's trade minister says export and import transactions with Israel will be stopped until the Israeli government allows the uninterrupted flow of humanitarian aid into Gaza. Ankara last month restricted exports to Israel, also due to the obstruction of aid. Israel's foreign minister slammed Turkey's latest action, saying it also disregards the interests of Turkish people and businessmen. In sports, the Indiana Pacers have finally reached the second round of the NBA playoffs. Obi Toppin led a balanced Indiana offense in their 120-98 series clinching game, make that Game 6 victory against the Milwaukee Bucks. Toppin finished with 21 points as the Pacers won a playoff series for the first time in a decade. The loss was a disappointing one for the Bucks, who had championship aspirations but lost superstar Giannis Antetokounmpo to injury in the first round of the postseason. More Hungarian families choose sustainable living to not only save on costs, but to lead a more environment-friendly life. Take a look.
These two Hungarian families are trying to live as sustainably as possible. Anecdotal evidence suggests it's a growing trend in the country, as some families try to save on costs of living, while others hope to escape a consumer-driven society or lead a more environmentally friendly life. 3 years ago, Laszlo Kamenci moved to a small farm in eastern Hungary with his wife Cynthia and young daughter Baroka. They keep their livestock free-range, grow their own vegetables, and slaughter or barter the meat they need. The family avoids using pesticides and digs as little land as possible to preserve a rich soil. Kamenci believes the land is effectively borrowed from his daughter, so he must preserve it for the future.
This land we have not inherited from our fathers, but we have it on loan from our children. They will continue to look after it, so we try to live and farm the land in a sustainable way.
The Kamencis also have trusted networks of like-minded people. They often trade food and other necessities with other families who choose a similar lifestyle.
This provides enough meat for about 2 months. Sometimes we smoke it, sometimes we freeze it, and sometimes we slaughter a pig for filling to make sausages. So about 5 such pigs are sufficient for one family for a whole year.
There are no official statistics on how many families are following a similar lifestyle in Hungary. Kamenci estimates there are around 1,000 families trying to embrace some form of sustainability. Some do it alone, while others are part of informal barter arrangements or structured eco-villages. Akos and Gabi Varga sold their IT and solar panel business 4 years ago and went to live on a farm in western Hungary.
We had no experience at all. We used to live in the city and we never did any gardening, but somehow we felt it in our heart that we really needed it. Obviously, not everyone will move from the city to the countryside. Not everyone has to live this life. But those who feel this in their hearts will be attracted to this kind of life so much that they will make their move, and there will be more and more of us.
But embarking on a fully self-sufficient lifestyle is not easy. And for Kamenci, that goal seems even unrealistic. His family currently does not live off-grid. They have the internet and buy electricity and gas for heating. They get by on less than $700 per month, some of which is spent on basics they cannot grow, like milk and sugar. But he says they do their best to rely minimally on external resources.
We don't want to change the world here. We don't want to save the world or become some kind of superheroes. There are plenty of those out there. We would like to produce most of what we need.